Hey guys, welcome back to our YouTube channel. It's your girl Fanulungu, back with another reaction video. If you're new to this channel, make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe. Like I said, my name is Fanulungu. You can check out my blog, Morning Coffee with Fanny, and feel free to read the amazing posts that I put out there, and yeah, just enjoy the entire content that I put out there. You can find us on Facebook and Instagram as Fanny and Jesse, and just feel free to interact with us. If there's something you guys want us to react to, drop the link in the comment section below, and we'll always more than be glad to react to it. And yeah, and thank you for 20,000 subscribers. You guys are the best. So today I'm going to be reacting to this, say this, Allah blocks laziness and gives you energy. Sounds very, very interesting. So without wasting time, let's get into the video.
I love you, Allah.
You know, the biggest problem we have with our worship is laziness. So how does one defeat laziness in life? You always seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help when it comes to your worship. And this is why from the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which he taught to Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu, he said to him, Ya Mu'adh, inni uhibbuka fillah. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is teaching Mu'adh something. Listen to what he teaches him. He's teaching him a dua. He said to him, Oh Mu'adh, I love you for the sake of Allah. Do not leave out after every salat that you say and make this dua, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Al-ulama rahimahumullah, they say that this dua is supposed to be said at the end of the salat before at-taslim. Before you make as-salam and you exit the salat, make the last dua you say, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrik. Oh Allah, give me the power and the strength and the ability to remember you. Give me the ability. Because on my own, I cannot do it. Because I'm lazy. But give me the ability to remember you. Wa shukrik. And the best of dhikr to Allah is the one that makes gratitude of Allah. Wa dhikrika wa shukrika. And to thank you. And the best of gratitude shown to Allah. Wa husni ibadatik. The excellent worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To master and perfect your worship. So you're asking Allah azza wa jal in this dua to give you the strength and the ability to remember Him, to be grateful to Him. And these two should lead to husni ibadatik, to perfect the worship for Allah Azza wa Jal. This is a dua you're supposed to say after every salat. You know, in the adhan, when the caller makes the adhan, we're supposed to repeat after the muadhin what he says. If he says, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, what are we supposed to say? Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. When does it change? When the muadhin says, Hayya ala salah, which means come to salah. Hayya ala al-falah, come to success. What are we supposed to say? We don't say hayya ala al-salah. We say la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. You know why? I'll tell you why. La hawla means I have no ability. I have no will. He's telling you come to salat. And you're saying la, I have no ability. Wa la quwwa, and I have no strength and no ability to come to salat whatsoever. Illa billah. Except if Allah was to give me permission. Then the word la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah is the greatest dhikr you're going to say when you're seeking Allah's help to continue in your worship and to defeat laziness. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he says that the people use the word la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah incorrectly. They use it incorrectly. He said people use it when there's a disaster or a calamity they're facing. Something of trouble happened. When trouble happens, you say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Ula hawla wa la quwwata illa billah is a dhikr you're supposed to say when you're feeling down, when you're feeling lazy. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, it's a door of the doors of the paradise. Meaning anyone who says it, it'll make the worship easy for him. And as a result, the door of the paradise opens for him. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, that it is a treasure of the treasures of the paradise. What does that mean? You know, the entire paradise is a treasure. But when the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that this word is a treasure in the paradise, meaning is it is a treasure compared to the treasure that's already in the paradise, that the reward of this word is so huge, it's a door of the paradise on its own. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in a hadith that la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah tahta al-arsh, it's underneath the arsh. From the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to say, Allahumma hdini, oh Allah, guide me. He didn't used to stop there. He used to say, wa yassiril huda li, and make guidance easy for me. Then we need to learn that we continuously and consistently ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He help us and aid us in our worship.
I loved this video, reason being that I myself have been busy the past couple of weeks. Let me just say, since September, I haven't been able to do as much as I would love to do. And this, I feel like it encourages you and actually tries to guide you on how you can go about your laziness. With this, I want to relate it to something, maybe homework. When we were younger, we would go to our parents, maybe we straight from primary, go to our parents and say, oh, we were given this homework, can I get assistance with this? I'm giving that example because the video actually said, I can't do this alone. There's a famous saying, no man is an island. You can't go through life just alone. If you want to go far in life, you have to involve other people so that your journey is made easier, or at least you have someone's guidance or someone to push you to do something. I guess that's the situation in this case. If we know we can't do something, if we know we're getting lazy at something, take a break, look at what you're doing, what you're not doing, what's distracting you, and how you can eliminate all those things. If you have to pray about it so that God can guide you. If you have to meditate about it so that you may be shown a way as to how you can cope and find that balance in life where you're actually doing something and just not wasting your time away. I don't know if I'm making sense. Otherwise, is there anything else? For now, no. But if there's something that you guys want to contribute, feel free and let me know what you do when you feel lazy, what pushes you, what motivates you to get back on track. And yeah, just feel free to interact with us. If there's something you want me to react to, drop the link in the comment section below and I'll be more than glad to react to it. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, do not forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in my next reaction video.